Hi, this is Harish here. Welcome to DB2 LUW Tips and Tricks video tutorial part 125. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about how the SU, the switch user command, and SCP, secure copy SCP command, conspires together, join hands together to sabotage the instance. So in simple words, the SU switch user command and the remote copy command or the secured copy command shuts down that DB2 instance. I don't know why. It's a very weird scenario. So the scripts that I'm using are freely available for download at db2luwacademy.blogspot.in. Please subscribe to my channel, youtube.com/db2luwacademy. My email is db2academy@gmail.com. And this slide talks about the problem scenario and the solution. The problem scenario is, we want to show you that the switch user command and the SCP command together, when the combination is used in a certain way, it shuts down the DB2 instance. It's kind of like, you know, abnormal end. You know, it's terminating abruptly. So for that to reproduce this issue, you need to start the instance by switching the user. So if you go and start the instance, like, usually the server is in some data center, so we use the PuTTY exe, right, the SSH utility. So when you do that, just log in with some different user ID and switch user SU-DB2INST1. So I'll be showing you that. So start the instance after, like, switching the user. Don't log in directly as DB2INST1 or the instance owner, and you start the instance by switching user, okay, to DB2INST1. So once you do that, the instance gets started. It will still run under DB2INST1 only. And after that, the instance is up, the database is active, and you're working. And just do a file transfer using the SCP command from any client to the DB2 server. That's it. Your instance will shut down. I don't know why that happens. The solution would be, obviously, like, start the instance without switching the user. Then your thing works. Otherwise, you can use WinSCP, FileZilla, or any other FTP tools that are available. So there are a lot of free tools and things available for this transfer. Or you can use SFTP also. But then you need to run an FTP server, right? So, but that's fine. Like, if you use any of these kind of tools, it's not a problem. But if you use the SCP command directly on the client machine, so that's when I face the problem. I really don't know. So the big question is, why? What is with SCP? Why it is behaving that way? I still don't have any answer for that. We cannot blame the SU command. I mean, the way you start the instance, it will be like seriously ridiculous to say that you cannot start the instance that way. Because right from the beginning of Unix, the switch user command is there. And whenever you switch the user, you can be as log in as any user, but you can always go and say SU-DB2INST1, assume the context of that user, and just start any programs. I mean, this is like, Unix is like, you know, inherently a multi-user system, right? So the switch user command is there right from the inception of Unix, I guess. So I'm not like a Linux expert or Unix expert, but I think it's such a very old command. And it shouldn't affect. So, but then, I don't know, this is a very, very weird scenario, and I don't know seriously why it happens to me always. I'm like the cursed guy here, so I don't know. Okay, so let me show you the scenario. So here I have my, like, the setup and everything up and running. So there are two Red Hat systems I'm using, and these are like the free version. There is a Red Hat developer program, so I just downloaded that, and this is like RHEL 7.2. So I am using Red Hat System 1 and Red Hat System 2. So the Red Hat System 2 is, and the SSH is configured, the SSH daemon is running between both these two servers. And like, I should be able to SSH from either of them or the SCP command for file transfer. So that is what I set it up, okay? And so these are the prerequisites. So you should have those things set up, and you just need, it's not anything to do with HADR or anything, just a simple instance, okay? You just have a simple instance, that's it. It's not even like a complicated scenario. So all you need to do is, so I'm going to this Red One system, so which will be, I would be calling like Red One system, log in directly as DB2INST1, and you can look, there is a file omg.txt, is a very, very simple file. Oh my god, why SU and SCP sabotaged the TB2 system? It has 3 lines of text. It's not much, okay. 54 bytes, that's it, okay. So, but then I just logged in directly as TB2 INST1. This is the red one system. So from here, I'll be uploading the file to the server, which is red 2. So red 2 also, I have a putty session. So this is my red 2 system. Please observe that I have logged in as Harish. So Harish is some user in that red 2 system. So I'm logging as Harish using the putty session, and then I'm going switching the user to INST1, and then I'm going to start the instance. Okay, I'm using a trial edition. So I just want to make sure that, you know, even in the advanced enterprise edition, this issue is there. I did it in Express C, it is there, but the demonstration, I'm using a trial edition software. So here, what I'm going to say, I have started the instance, so I'll activate the database. So let's say, yeah, activate, bingo, that's the database. And you can see in PS command, obviously the instance is up and running. I can even say db2pd-edus, like all the things are up and running. So everything is fine, right? So what you need to do is, okay, I'll show it one more time. The instance is up and running. SysC process is running with a particular process ID under db2inst1 only, obviously. So why it would, the switch user has no effect, right? So you can start the instance. You are starting the instance as inst1 only because you are switching user. All you need to do is, okay, make sure that there is no file here. There's no omg.txt file here, so which is what I'm going to upload now. So just go there to the client system. So I just want to do SCP. Okay, so whether I say -2 or -1, it doesn't matter. So I'll just say SCP, that's the file. I want to upload it to red2 system, okay? db2inst1 at red2, the home directory of the inst1. So it's going to ask for the password, so I'm just going to do that. It got transferred, like in no time it will transfer. Obviously it's a fast transfer. Let's come to the red2 machine. We see that the transfer is done. Okay, that's it. The system is gone for a toss. So something is happening. Okay, I would say more omg.txt. That's it. It's hanged. Okay, it was a bit slow, so it's not essentially hanging. Okay, so that's fine. So the file got transferred, successful. But what happened to my instance? Gone. Who shut down my instance? I just did a SCP file transfer from the client system to the server using SCP command. And this happens very, very peculiarly. This happens only if I start the instance under the switch user mode. I'll show you what I mean. So let me just go and remove the omg.txt, okay? And I'm exiting. So in any case, now the instance is not started. It got abruptly killed. So I'm gonna exit, okay? So this session, I just keep it, and I'm going to start another putty session. Okay, and I'm going to go into the red2 system, which is my server, 192.168.56.112, okay? And I'm going to log in this time directly as db2inst1, okay? And db2inst1, okay? And there is no that file, so I'm going to start the instance, and I'm going to activate the database. Okay, I'll maximize the screen. I have to activate the database, and I'll run the db2pd. Yeah, this is C process is there, 3802. And you can see the EDUs also if you want. Okay, all up and running. Okay, now for the fun part, do the same transfer. Initiate the same transfer now again. It's done. Okay. Come back here. There you go. The way you started the instance is affecting something. And that's like the switch user. And the combination with SCP. I don't know what is this. I seriously don't know why it happens to me every time. So this works now. The non-working scenario is like, you just go and start the instance by switching user to DB to INST1 and then do a SCP transfer from any of the client machine. Like, I do have the program FileZilla, so I use for the FTP transfer from the Windows machine to the server, and that works fine. It's only the SCP command. So the combination of the switch user starting the instance and the SCP command of file transfer from the client to the server, then the server itself will be shut down. I don't know why. This is all default SSH installation, no configurations or anything. Only I have configured the SSH, like in both the client and the server, the SSH processes are running. So that's the only thing that you need to set up for SSH. And I have not modified anything. It's all default setup, default configuration, no special things or anything done. Only the thing I had done was like, passwordless authentication was set up, but that's for root user. I have set up only the passwordless authentication for the root user. I did not change anything for the INST1 user, but then it is not working. So this is the thing. This is the mess that I'm talking about. I saw in the dialog, so the dialog, I see that there are a lot of log messages. The watchdog process is getting killed. So eventually the watchdog process, if it is getting killed, the instance is also going to come down. It's an abnormal end in the dialog. Yeah, just do let me know if you are also facing the same issue. And it's a very, very simple thing. And it is a very peculiar thing as well. It works only in one certain situation. So yeah, that's the tip that I wanted to provide you this time. So hope this was useful to you. Please subscribe to my channel, youtube.com/db2luwacademy. See you in the next video tutorial. Until then, bye-bye.